Welcome back to Combat Tech. I'm Steven, and today we're diving into the world of drone warfare and U.S. counter-unmanned aerial systems. A lone drone appears on the horizon, barely a speck in the sky. But within seconds, that tiny unmanned aircraft could drop an explosive, jam your communications, or relay intel to its operator half a world away. This is the new face of warfare, and it's more widespread than ever. From the war in Ukraine, where drones shape everyday battles, to the Red Sea, where Houthi rebels target merchant vessels, unmanned systems are changing the rules of engagement. Yet, the United States is not sitting idle. A suite of counter-unmanned aerial systems, C-UAS for short, has emerged, designed to detect, disable, and even destroy drones in mid-flight. And the most astonishing breakthrough, one that few saw coming, will be unveiled later in this video. Stay tuned. From the battlefields of eastern Ukraine, where both sides rely heavily on quadcopters for surveillance and target spotting, to the tumultuous waters of the Red Sea, drones have become the weapon of choice for asymmetric warfare. Houthi forces have deployed DIY drones to menace merchant ships and even US Navy vessels, highlighting just how easily this technology can be weaponized. Meanwhile, Israel, long recognized for its advanced defense systems, has witnessed a surge in drone incursions, forcing it to adapt to this fast-moving threat. Why is it so urgent? Because drones are inexpensive, accessible, and can be devastatingly effective. They're often small enough to evade radar, but sturdy enough to deliver powerful payloads. At any moment, that buzz in the sky might herald a surprise attack on critical infrastructure, a mobile convoy, or a densely populated city. So how do you stop something so small, elusive, and potentially lethal? Let's take a closer look at the cutting-edge tech America is deploying and the challenges that come with it. According to official reports, the proliferation of drones, both commercial and military, has never been higher. Over 100 countries and countless non-state actors have some form of unmanned aerial system. Whether it's a non-state militia rigging a hobby drone with explosives or a state actor fielding a fleet of advanced UAVs, the urgency is real. But the US military isn't caught off guard. A variety of systems, collectively known as C-UAS, counter-unmanned aerial systems, have been developed. Each one tackles a piece of the drone threat puzzle: detection and tracking, spotting these tiny intruders on radar or infrared, disruption and interdiction, jamming or hijacking control signals, kinetic or a directed energy kill, physically shooting them down or frying their circuitry. And there's more than just one silver bullet solution. In the next scene, we'll explore the multi-layered approach that includes everything from portable jammers like Drone Gun Tactical to high-tech laser systems like Helios. Trust me, you'll want to see what lasers are doing on the deck of a US warship. Stopping a drone is surprisingly complex. That's why the Pentagon and other US defense bodies favor a layered solution. Let's break down some of the standout systems. EXMATIS, Expeditionary Mobile Air Defense Integrated System. A portable Marine Corps system that combines radar, electro-optical sensors, and electronic warfare. It can identify a drone's location, then jam its control signals, forcing it to land or crash. Perfect for rapid response teams in unpredictable environments. AUDS, Anti-UAV Defense System. A British-American collaboration that integrates radar, camera, and RF jamming. It's designed to spot, track, and disrupt UAVs in real time, often used to protect high-value sites like airbases or forward operating bases. MLIDS, Mobile Low, Slow, Small Unmanned Aerial Vehicle Integrated Defense System. An Army program that mounts advanced sensors and jammers on a vehicle, enabling on-the-go protection against drones, especially those that fly low and slow to avoid radar. Drone Gun Tactical. Think of it as an anti-drone rifle. This handheld jammer breaks communication between the drone and its operator. It can force the UAV to land safely for forensic analysis or drive it away. Helios, high energy laser with integrated optical dazzler and surveillance. A cutting-edge Navy system that uses a powerful laser to burn or disable drones at sea, paired with an optical dazzler to confuse enemy sensors. It doubles as a surveillance asset, giving ships a heads up before engaging threats. HELWS, High Energy Laser Weapon System. A land-based laser solution from Raytheon, it can be mounted on vehicles or fixed sites, ideal for zapping drones without using up expensive kinetic rounds. And that's only scratching the surface. Up next, we'll spotlight the futuristic power of high-powered microwaves and drone-on-drone interception, two game-changers rewriting the rules of aerial combat. Lasers aren't the only high-tech way to stop a rogue UAV. Meet THOR, Tactical High Power Operational Responder, a microwave-based system that blasts drones with an electromagnetic wave, frying their circuitry in a single pulse. perfect for swarms. Launch one microwave burst, and you could disable multiple UAVs simultaneously. Then there's Coyote Block 2 by Raytheon, a small interceptor drone that hunts down hostile UAVs. Think of it like a guided missile meets miniature plane, capable of direct collision or proximity blasts. It's expendable, agile, and can operate in tough weather conditions where lasers might struggle. Fortem DroneHunter is another star in the drone versus drone lineup. Rather than blowing the target to bits, it fires a net to snare the intruder, letting operators analyze the captured drone later. This is crucial in espionage scenarios where gleaning intel can be as valuable as neutralizing the threat. All these systems highlight a critical evolution in modern warfare. We're in an era where dogfights may soon be UAV versus UAV, but fancy gadgets alone won't win the day. Next, we'll see how recent conflicts, like Ukraine and Houthi engagements in the Red Sea, are forcing the US to adapt even faster. If you want a glimpse of the future, look no further than the headlines. In Ukraine, both sides deploy small, off-the-shelf drones for reconnaissance, artillery spotting, and even makeshift bombing runs. These UAVs can turn the tide of a skirmish in minutes, and they're cheap enough to replace en masse. Meanwhile, the Houthis in Yemen have targeted merchant vessels and US Navy ships in the Red Sea. Their drones aren't advanced by Western standards, but they don't need to be. Even improvised UAVs can threaten critical choke points like the Bab el-Mandeb Strait. On a different front, Israel frequently intercepts UAVs launched by hostile groups, testing its air defense systems like Iron Dome in ways previously unimagined. These real-world flashpoints reveal two things. First, drones are here to stay, becoming a staple of both state and non-state military strategy. Second, effective countermeasures can save lives and protect crucial assets, yet they must constantly evolve to handle an ever-shifting threat. Coming up, we'll explore the strategic and ethical challenges of deploying C-UAS technology. If you're finding this deep dive fascinating, hit the like button and subscribe for more insights on cutting-edge military tech. And tell us in the comments, what new technology do you think will redefine warfare next? High-energy lasers, microwaves, drone interceptors, these are amazing feats of innovation. But they're not without pitfalls. One key challenge is distinguishing friend or foe in crowded skies. A camera drone filming a sporting event could be mistaken for a threat. On the flip side, a hostile UAV might slip through if the system is overly cautious. Rules of engagement, ROE, present another minefield. Deploying a laser or microwave in a civilian area risks collateral damage, disrupting communications, harming bystanders, or damaging infrastructure. Kinetic methods, like missiles, can be even riskier if debris falls in populated zones. The cost factor also looms large. Can you justify launching a pricey missile at a $500 drone? Systems like HELLS or Drone Gun Tactical offer more cost-effective per-shot solutions, but the upfront investment is significant. Finally, there's the risk of an arms race. As the US ramps up advanced C-UAS tech, adversaries adapt, employing stealth drones, advanced AI, or new tactics like launching swarms at multiple angles. This back-and-forth evolution could escalate tensions globally. And yet, we're only scratching the surface. When AI enters the fray, controlling swarms of UAVs at once, the battlefield changes forever. Stick around because the next segment unveils a system so advanced, even experts are in awe. Imagine 50 drones approaching your base in a synchronized attack, each one weaving to avoid radar and launching decoys to fool your defenses. In response, your own defender swarm leaps into action, armed with net launchers, jammers, or tiny warheads. But who's calling the shots? An AI that makes microsecond decisions, far faster than any human could react. This isn't science fiction. The US military is already experimenting with AI-driven control nodes that can manage friendly drone swarms and coordinate with ground-based or shipborne C-UAS assets like Helios or THOR. The ultimate goal? A seamless network where a threat pops up on radar. The AI sorts through options, laser, microwave, kinetic interceptor, or a combination, and executes the best plan, often without waiting for human approval. But is that level of autonomy really what we want? What if AI misidentifies a friendly craft or malfunctions in the heat of battle? These questions loom, forcing policymakers to weigh the benefits of rapid, automated defense against the moral and strategic risks of letting machines make life or death calls. Meanwhile, swarms aren't just about quantity. In future scenarios, each drone might specialize, one carrying advanced sensors, another hosting a jamming module, others physically intercepting the threat. If the AI or control node determines a drone is damaged or jammed, it can call in a replacement unit, making the system resilient. Still, adversaries won't stand by. we can expect stealth codings, advanced electronic warfare, and more robust encryption. The battlefield is turning into a chess match, with moves and countermoves happening at blinding speed. And speaking of speed, there's one more invention rumored to revolutionize how fast we can protect our skies. We'll reveal it shortly, so don't blink. Insiders whisper about a next-gen system combining machine learning, drone-on-drone interception, and directed energy into a single platform. It's said to unify data from radars, satellites, and local ground sensors, delivering near-instant strike responses. Rumor has it prototypes can take down multiple UAVs faster than current operators, can even confirm IDs. Though details remain classified, experts say this platform could handle saturation attacks where dozens of drones strike simultaneously, an unprecedented feat. If and when it goes live, it could usher in an era of near fully autonomous air defense. But remember, technology only races ahead if policy, training, and strategy keep pace. And that's where our final chapter begins. We've seen how the war in Ukraine, Houthi tactics in the Red Sea, and attacks against Israel have put drones in the global spotlight. We've explored high-tech solutions like X-MATIS, ADS, M-LIDS, Drone Gun Tactical, Hell-Ws, THOR, Coyote Block 2, Fortem DroneHunter, and the Navy's Helios system, each playing its part to secure the skies. It's a high-stakes race, where small, cheap drones can threaten billion-dollar assets, and where next-gen defenses evolve as quickly as the threats. But questions of cost, ethics, and AI autonomy remain. Will we soon see AI-driven swarms policing the skies, deciding targets in milliseconds? Or will a balanced approach keep humans in the loop? If you found this journey enlightening, do us a favor. Hit the like button and subscribe for more deep dives into modern military tech. And don't forget to comment below, which new technology do you think will change warfare next?